Students, today we'll study another poem from your class 11 syllabus, The Voice of the Rain. It is written by Walt Whitman. He's a very contemporary poet. This particular poem is from your book Hornbill. In this particular video, we'll be doing the poetic devices and the detailed explanation of this particular poem. So, coming to the introduction, the poem is actually a dialogue and conversation between the poet and the rain, where the rain calls itself the poem of the earth and explains its entire life cycle. Rising from the sea and the land in vaporous form, the raindrops fall back, giving the world a relief from the droughts. It brings the dormant seeds to life, and by quenching the thirst of the earth once again, it heads for a fresh life cycle. A parallel is also drawn between rain and the music. Both try to make life more livable. Now coming to the first stanza, "And who art thou, said I, to the soft falling shower?" So the poet is seeing the, fascinated by the spontaneity and the soothing effects of the rain. The poet asks it to give its introduction. It says, "Who art thou, who are you, said I, to the soft falling shower," said I to the raindrops which are falling softly on the land. Which strange to tell, so the poet is himself surprised that how come the rain answers back, gave me an answer as he had translated. And this is what the rain said. "I am the poem of the earth," said the voice of the rain. "Eternal I rise, impalpable, out of the land and the bottomless sea." Eternal means from years, from long ago I have been rising, impalpable. Impalpable means without being seen, without being touched. "Out of the land and the bottomless sea, where does the rain, how does the rain form clouds? The water from the land and the sea gets evaporated and forms finally clouds." So that is what it says, that eternal, from years I've been rising in the vaporous form from the land and the bottomless sea. So fascinated by the spontaneity and the soothing effects of the rain, the poet asked it to give its introduction. To his great surprise, the rain did introduce itself and called itself the poem of the earth and gives a detailed account of its cyclic movement. Unnoticed by the people around, the vapors rise as clouds from the moon of the earth and the unfathomable sea. "I am the poem of the earth" is a personification. Rain here answers back to all the queries of the poet. That is why, like a normal person, so it is personification. Poem of the earth is a metaphor. Here, raindrops is compared to the poem. So, hyperbole, bottomless sea. You cannot measure the sea water. You do not know exactly how much water is inside the sea. By the time you finally measure, take out the volume, so much of water might have been evaporated or so much of river water must have entered in. So that is why it is hyperbole. Coming to the second stanza, "Upward to heaven whence vaguely form, altogether changed and yet the same." So the rain says that finally I rise up to the heaven, whence means where, vaguely form. So the raindrops forms vague shapes, the clouds shape is not fixed. And if you've seen the clouds, sometimes they take the shape of a bear, or sometimes a rhinoceros or dog or something. So it takes different sort of shapes, together changed and yet the same. So the physical state of the matter of the water is not changed. If you see, initially the water was in liquid form, then while it was rising up, it was in the vaporous form, that is the gaseous state, and while it was in the clouds, it is taken the shape of clouds. So the physical state of the water has changed, but the chemical properties are still the same. It is still water only, and yet that's why it is saying altogether changed and yet the same. I descend means I fall down to lave the droughts. Lave means to wash away the droughts. Once there is a drought, say sukha, so once the raindrops fall on it, so there will be no more droughts around. So atom is dust layers of the globe. Whatever small tiny atoms of dust might be moving around in the atmosphere, so all of them get settled by the weight of the raindrops. And all that in them without me were seeds only, latent and unborn. So raindrops give rise, germinate the new plants. So those seeds would remain latent. Latent means soyava, unborn. They will remain dormant till the time raindrops fall on them and give rise to new life. In the sky, raindrops form vaguely shaped, not distinct shaped clouds. In spite of this transformation, this vapor turned water basically remains the same. The rain then falls from heaven above, quenching the thirst and showering its benevolence on everything around and quelling the drought. helping in the germination of seeds. It stirs life into the dormant seeds. Altogether changed and yet the same. Here, changed and same are two opposites, and yet the are the three words which are in between changed and same. So the poetic devices is antithesis. Coming to the third stanza, and forever by day and night, I give back life to my own origin. So this cycle of forming raindrops and falling down in the form of rain is continuous. It keeps on happening throughout. So I make and purify it. So rain water is the purest form of water. So for song issuing from his birthplace after fulfillment, watering rector and land to be withdrawn. So rain is compared to music, just like a music heals you, just like it has a very calming effect on you. Similarly, rain also has a very calming effect on everybody. You feel very nice when the rain falls down. Rector and rec. Once the Where does the song issue from? It comes out, emanates from the singer. Similarly, raindrops emanates from the clouds. So, I give back life to my own origin also is the same thing. See, once, suppose, how does the raindrops life start, life cycle of the rain start? It starts from the water being evaporated as a younger stage and the formation of cloud, which is the adult stage, and finally falling down, it is a death stage. And again, the same process starts. Again, the birth, the young age, and then the death stage. So that is why it says, I give back life to my own origin. So similarly, it compares to the music. So song issuing from the birthplace. See, where does the song issue from? From the person who is singing it. And where does the rain issue from? It issues from the clouds. So similarly, raindrops are impartial to everybody. So they fall on you also and the person who might be moving along with you. So similarly, a song also. If you are singing, sitting in an auditorium or something and somebody starts singing, all of you will be hearing it in a similar fashion. So, and a song after singing, after the fulfillment, after rejoicing everybody, comes back to the singer. Similarly, raindrops after fulfillment goes back to its own cycle. So by drenching the earth, it prepares ground for another life cycle. Thus, incessant and continuous process keeps on enhancing the beauty of the earth and purifies it. Towards the end of the poem, a parallel is drawn between the rain and the music. Just as the rain originates from the womb of the earth, music also emanates from the heart of the singer. Rain falling all over drenches everything, preparing to start another life cycle. Music also reverberates all over, irrespective whether someone listens to it or not. It echoes in the heart of the singer, evading a sense of joy and satisfaction. Quite akin to each other, the rain and music make life more livable. In the last two lines are put in brackets because rain has now stopped speaking. A lot of times the question is asked, why are the last two lines in brackets? Because no longer the rain is speaking. The poet is imagining, it's an afterthought of the poet. So that is why it is put in brackets. Now coming to this poetic devices, day, night. If you see in the first line, day and night, there is a word and in between day and night, there are two opposites. So the poetic devices, antithesis. Regged or unregged are two opposites, and or is in between. Again, the poetic devices, antithesis. I hope you've understood the poem. Happy learning. If you really like this video, please do like, share, or subscribe. Thank you.